Hi guys, welcome to my channel. Just want to do a quick review on the Bose 700 soundbar. We've just got it the last fortnight. We've just sort of properly set it up. We've been waiting for a new carpet and a new cabinet coming. I didn't see the point of having it banged about. Anyway, it's my first Bose product and it's absolutely bloody fantastic. 800 quid, a lot of money for a soundbar, but there's so much bass on this, it's stupid. I don't even think you really need the subwoofer, to be honest, unless you're an absolute semi-detached massive house person. I don't really see the point. The bass is beautiful on it, every tone. I've never heard sound like it, to be honest. I've never had a Bose before. I've also never had a Sonos before, so to me it's excellent. Setting up pretty good. Turn it on, get it on the Ethernet cable. Doesn't seem to be wireless, so all you got at the back is a power Ethernet. And the HDMI arc we're using for it. It does come with an optical cable for obviously digital optical if you haven't got an arc. Most tellies have these days, I think. Easy setup. Like I said, Alexa built in. Alexa, what's the temperature outside?
Right now, it's 10 degrees.
Just has a small today, indicator light comes on here when it's doing things. Failing that, everything's quiet on here unless you're connecting Bluetooth. Obviously if you go Bluetooth on this beautiful remote, which I'll show you in a minute, it's waiting for its connection there. Your remote, I'll just quickly go over the remote. You've got your Sky button there, so you can control your Sky if you wish with this controller. It won't control everything on my telly, but it does all the general stuff. It won't like take me to apps for YouTube, whether or not that's something I haven't got set up. It only shows you things that are relevant to what you're setting up. Obviously now we're in music mode, it's just lighting up these. If you move it, it comes on again. TV mode, the whole controller comes on. And like I showed you before, Bluetooth mode there, just the play things and the volume, things that you'd be interested in. So just put it back onto there. That's lovely, it's rubberized. It feels fantastic in the hand. Got the lovely Bose logo on the bottom, and it has four AA's in the back of it. Obviously for its backlight feature, I'm guessing. It's probably a bit hungry on the battery, but then again, as soon as you stop moving it, it goes off anyway. So that's a great power saving feature. like I said, the Bose, once we got connected with an Ethernet cable, powered up the arc in, we turned the unit on. We went into the Alexa app and asked it to find it, which it did, and then immediately took us to Amazon, set itself up in our account. Absolutely fantastic. I can't say enough about it. The quality is just ridiculous. We're the first people in Bury to buy one. That's in Lancashire, UK, if you're watching from anywhere else. Another little feature it has, it comes with these strange little plastic headset. It's got a microphone in the top, really long cable. You plug this into the back of the unit, takes about a second. You run the Adaptec application within the Bose app, which is really easy. And it basically plays a series of different tones and asks you to sit in your favorite place, asks you to sit somewhere else. And you sit in, I think there's five places around the room, and it tunes the Bose 700 to the acoustics of your room. And we had it obviously untuned while we initially had it, because we had a glass cabinet, not a wooden one. We had floorboards, not a carpet. We've changed all that round and decided to run the application, and my God, what a difference. It's just chalk and cheese. I mean, if it didn't sound good enough before, you know, after you run that application, you play it, it's just amazing. The sound quality, I cannot say enough about it. It's got this beautiful glass top on it, obviously the Bose logo there, nicely, you know, like a drilled metal surround all around it, in a dark grey. It's almost black to look at. beautiful. I can't say enough about this. £800 for that unit. There's a lot of money, I know, but it'll last you forever. We were talking about getting the Bose 700 sub for it. Apparently the 500 will work with it, but I'm not guaranteeing that. But the 700 sub is £700. And the small surround sound speakers, I think they call them virtually invisible speakers or such like, they're £300 a pair. We've not bought them yet. That'll probably be on the next Christmas list, but I don't think we'll be bothering with the sound bar because it's just bassy enough. I mean, you're not going to hear it on here at all. But what I'll quickly show you is on the Bose application. I don't know how much of this you're going to get on here, but I'm not actually monitoring what I'm showing you. But we'll go to the Bose app there. It's the Bose Music app is the one that works with the 700. Obviously, you can go into the speaker there. You can do all your adjustments of your bass, your treble, and your center channel. Or you can go into settings. These are your voice assistant. If you're sharing it publicly, so that means somebody else can come in your house with the Bose app and take over the Bose. We've left ours on that at the moment. What your buttons do, I think you can reprogram buttons to do certain things. The Adaptik application, that was just explaining with the headphones, that's on there. Just all sorts of stuff. The technical info, it basically tells you your serial number, your internet, if you're online, it's wired obviously. It doesn't seem to have wireless on it. I don't know if I haven't found it yet. MAC address, blah, blah, blah. All that stuff's on there. And then you can go into the Just For You section and it'll show you top tracks, things that you've been playing, whatever. Or you can go into the Amazon Music section, which we've obviously got Amazon because we've got Alexas around the house. And again, a load of stuff in here. Let's click on popular, for example. Let's click on top tracks. And there's absolutely loads and loads and loads. So you can just set it up the whole evening with whatever you want. Okay, so we're actually playing now in the background. I'll just click on something else and I'll turn it up. I know you're not going to hear it, but believe me, the sound is absolutely ridiculous on this thing. It's beautiful.
Okay, okay. I see what's happening, yeah. You're face to face with greatness and it's true.
Put something a bit more normal on there. And all nine are we watching this? That there, when you're in pause mode, I'm not sure if you'll see this off the camera, there's two little lights come up here. It really is very little indication of what it's doing, which is nice because it's not too distracting but just tells you exactly enough, you know, of what you need to know really. But that's sort of about it really. Like I said, the first Bose thing I've ever bought, definitely won't be the last. We'll probably be buying the surround sound speakers, your background speakers if you like, and we'll probably buy another speaker for in the conservatory. The only thing I have noticed though, I don't know if anybody can leave me a comment below, when you're on the Alexa app, you can normally add or group your Amazon Alexa devices like your Spot or your Echo or whatever, so that you can say, you know, Alexa, play this everywhere. This doesn't seem to want to go into a group on there. I don't know why, but if I tell Alexa to play such and such on the Bose, it just says you need to enable the skill. I've downloaded the 3 applications at the Play Store, tried to set them up, and doesn't make any difference. Alexa just says you need to enable this skill in the Alexa app, which I have. Now, from what I can see, I don't think there is an application out for the 700 yet. I think it's for the SoundTouch systems and maybe the 5 and 300. And I think that's what the problem is. Until the app comes out for the 700, I don't think it's integrating properly quite with Alexa at the moment, but to be honest, it's a small moan really. The sound, like I said, is fantastic. I just put it on as soon as I get up. On a Sunday, I'm on my own till later on. So I'll just put on any tracks I want, a playlist, Sunday specials, the radio, anything you want. It's just absolutely beautiful. I absolutely love it. I've had a couple of little issues with the network dropping off on it. You know, you'll ask Alexa to do something and it won't listen. It won't hear you, or the red light will come on to say it can't do this at the moment. But I found out it's actually my Ethernet cable was a bit dodge, so I've got that swapped now and not had a problem since, so it's probably just that. To reset the unit, because I reset it a couple times, because at first, when we first got it, we didn't realise, but we'd had the mute button pushed on the bar, and from on the settee over there, it looks just like it was in the standby mode, so it wouldn't work. Obviously I was saying, Alexa, 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 nothing's happening at all, and then I realised after some time, it was just that little button that was down. So that was that really, but failing that, beautiful bit of kit. Any questions, please leave me a comment below. Like I say, glass top, it's all black, it's beautiful to look at. I'm not going to turn it over. Sockets on the back are basically your power, your Ethernet, your ARC, optical, which we're not using in this case, and obviously the TV turns the soundbar on when it comes on that way automatically. There is a few others. There's a bass one, like a small jack. I don't know if that's for a wired bass, I'm not sure. There's a service port and something else, but you can see all that. If you download the Bose 700 manual online, you'll see what it's got on the back. I'm not tipping all mine up now because I've got it just as I like it, but I hope you like this review anyway. It definitely won't be the last Bose product I buy, so hope you enjoy it. £800, we went to Spatial Sounds in Bury in Lancashire to get it. Two lovely guys in the shop were happy to demonstrate it. When I first heard it, I thought they've definitely got a sub on this hidden in the shop, but the guy showed me on the app that it was just a soundbar, there was no sub attached. Obviously if you add a sub, it comes up on the app. So brilliant. You won't need a sub, guys, with this on. In a normal house, you won't need a sub. So I hope you've enjoyed the video anyway, and look out for some more. I'll catch you later. All the best.